Hi guys, welcome to another video. This is Utkarsh, and in today's video we are going to talk about how to keep your SIM, Indian SIM, active in the United States. So without any ado, let's get started, okay? So a lot of you guys have texted me on Instagram and on my Facebook, you know, you were asking like, you know, the Vodafone plans that you have in India and the Idea plan, the different plans, the Indian prepaid, postpaid plans that you have, how do you keep them active? Because obviously, like, you know, if you're like me, someone like me, I'm attached to my number, okay? I want my number to remain active because if you're going to the United States to study or do, or you know, you're going for quite a while, right? Like minimum, if your course is like a year long too, if you don't use your Indian SIM for like a year, obviously, you know, the number will go to someone else and you'll lose the number. So these companies are very smart and they've worked on that. So, you know, I'll just give down the list of all the different ways and how do you keep your SIM active, okay? And this is only and only for students, okay, and not for other people. So if you're someone, if you're going for a business travel or like, you know, you're just going for a vacation or for like a smaller duration or period of time, this is not recommended for you. This is only for students who are going to the United States from India specifically, and how can they keep the SIM active in the United States, okay? So firstly, I'll start with Vodafone, okay? One is Vodafone. Since I have Vodafone, okay? So Vodafone is, you just need to get the basic international roaming plan, okay? In this, you won't get any data, you won't get any unlimited free calling, outgoing and incoming, okay? They all are chargeable. Only thing that you get is, you get unlimited incoming messages and you get it for free, okay? So whatever your bank OTPs, your text messages, your SMSs, whatever you get, all those are free. But if you call to India or if you call anywhere else or if you text anyone else on SMS or use internet, all chargeable. Okay, so this is the most cheapest way to keep your Vodafone SIM active, okay? This works for both postpaid and prepaid services and they have different rates. So for the prepaid plan, it's 99 rupees per month. For the postpaid plan, it's 149 rupees per month. Now, you can have that Vodafone app in which monthly you can do this payment and you can keep your SIM active as long as you're in the United States to whoever you have, your parents or you know your family or whoever is there, they can go and do the payment. So this way you can do your payment even when you're not in the country and you can keep your Vodafone SIM both postpaid and prepaid active, okay? Second, we talk about Airtel, okay? So in Airtel, we'll discuss both the postpaid and prepaid plans, okay? So to enable roaming, Airtel charges a fixed amount of 99 rupees, okay? So firstly, we'll talk about the prepaid card. In the prepaid card, Airtel charges a fixed income of rupees 99. So now what does this contain, okay? So this is the basic plan, like the Vodafone basic plan, where wherein the calls, the outgoing calls, the incoming calls using data, all are chargeable and it's pretty expensive, okay? Since these are plans I'm telling you to just keep your SIM active, okay, I wouldn't recommend to use any of these plans, other plans also, okay. So for rupees 99, you'll get unlimited incoming SMSs. You'll get it for free, okay, your bank OTPs, your other details, you'll get it for free. So this is the prepaid plan in Airtel, okay. Now, alright, now going for the postpaid plans in Airtel, there are two types of plans in postpaid. There's the rupees 23 plan and the rupees 35 plan. I'll tell you about the rupees 23 plan in great detail. So this is the plan wherein, you know, you'll get unlimited incoming SMSs and it's very cheap. It's only for 23 bucks. And you'll get your bank OTPs and all, you know, the whole thing, the whole package. And again, it's same like, you know, unlike Vodafone, you'll have to, if you have the Airtel app, you can do the online payment from whichever part of the country you are in the United States or in the United States, wherever you are, you can do that. Or you can tell your family members to go and, you know, in physicality, go and do the payment. That way your number will remain active in Airtel, both postpaid and prepaid, okay? The Airtel has specific designed these plans only, okay? Airtel and Vodafone, so as to sustain customers and especially students like us, who are going abroad and you know who don't want to get rid of them. They want their number like after a couple of years when you come back to India, you'll have the same number, you know, so you don't have to do the whole portability, like changing the number and all of that, because it's a hassle, right? You have your number for a while, so why not stick to it? So yeah, these are the two major service providers. like we're talking about major service provider, let's talk about Jio now, which is the third. How do you keep your SIM active in Jio when you're in the USA? Okay, first and foremost thing, once you reach the United States, you'll realize Jio doesn't work. You know, I've spoken to a lot of seniors and they said it's shit. So if you have Jio, I think you'll have a very tough time because Jio is bullshit when it comes to, you know, its customer service and its international roaming and data plans and all of that. It boasts and it markets and talks about a lot of plans, you know, wherein you can get the same plan where you can keep a number active and, you know, still get SMSs of bank OTPs and stuff like that. Incoming SMSs are free, but it never really works. I've hardly found anyone for whom it's worked, so I won't get into details of it because it's pointless. So I would recommend to you guys, like if you have Jio and if you have time, if you can do the whole portability thing, get to Vodafone or Airtel, it'll be better. And then you can follow the steps which I mentioned in 1 and 2 previously. Fourthly, I'll discuss Idea. Okay. In Idea, you have to... So for Idea, you have to do the whole international roaming. You have to activate it. Okay. But in this case, what happens is like in Vodafone and Airtel, right? You don't have to... It's the basic plan where you have to activate it. Okay. Whereas in Idea, so Idea how it works is there are multiple plans, okay? So you need to choose the plan which is the cheapest and the best for you, okay? There is no plan like how it was in case of Airtel and or Vodafone, which is like, you know, you can go abroad and you can get unlimited SMSs, text messages, like bank OTPs and stuff like that without even activating the, you know, international roaming plan. Whereas in Idea you have to. So I didn't mention this earlier, but in Vodafone and Airtel you don't have to. Actually in this case you have to. So since you have to, so choose a plan where not only SMSs are free, right, where you get some incoming calls and outgoing calls towards some messages, okay, whatever. So if you're an Idea customer, your deal should be like you should choose a plan which is best for you, you know, which suits you the best, where you can get the maximum benefits for the least amount of price, obviously, right? As a customer, that's a main deal. So yeah, this is the four major service providers and how do you keep your SIM active if you have these four major service providers. So I wanted to just discuss that because a lot of you guys were texting and, you know, there wasn't any concrete answer about this and people didn't know where to look at. So I made this video and yeah, I would recommend you to, you know, use it like once you reach the United States, open, you know, get a SIM from there only, because a lot of advantages. You will keep your SIM active, but don't get into the thing that you want to use, you know, the roaming thing, because it's very expensive. The whole international roaming, you know, you won't even get that much data. You'll have a lot of network issues and stuff like that. So I wouldn't recommend that. So as soon as you reach there, like what, couple of days, you can use this. But again, you can't do the whole calling and texting thing. Well, you can, but you'll have to pay a lot. So yeah, use as much as Wi-Fi as possible, and as soon as possible when you land in the United States, get a SIM card, which is very important. Yeah, that's about it. If you have any doubts, do hit us down in the comment section below. Our Instagram is at that college page. You can always hit us there. We're always active there. And yeah, do like, comment, share, and subscribe, because you watched till here, you know, might as well like it. It doesn't cost you anything. And thank you for watching the video. Bye-bye.